In this section of the classroom, I have the current learning goals. Every time I start a unit in every subject, we read it together. We talk about this because to me it's very important that my students know what it is that they're going to be learning about. So once I have used it several times, I have it at the front when I'm doing my lessons. What is it that we are working in language? And sometimes they don't remember, or sometimes they do. I show them the card. At some point then I tell them, okay, it's time to put the card on the board. So it comes over here. This is an idea of knowing exactly what we are working on and why we're doing it. For example, in language, I have learning goals for reading, which is becoming a better reader. But in writing right now, we're working on prediction, inferencing and prediction. So you can see here that it says, I will learn and practice how to infer and predict and how to explain my prediction. So that's the learning goal. And I told them that particular part of explain my prediction, it means saying why. Why do you think that that's what's going to happen next? And at the end of the unit, we go back to the learning goal. Did we get the results? Did we learn this? Yes, okay, good. So it's time to move on to a new unit. Another example, in math, we are working right now with measuring length and area of objects. We keep working with solving math problems. So that's something that I keep going back and I use all the time. So as you can see here, the learning goals for math relate to those things. This is also a really good tool for me as a teacher because I have organized all these cards based on the curriculum expectations. These cards is just so easy to say, okay, this is what I'm going to be teaching next. And of course, I use this also when I'm planning because I know that for this week, this is the unit that we're going to be working on. It matches my annual plan and my weekly plan. You know, it's just an easy way for me to see what's coming next.